Dear friends in Christ, on this most holy night in which our Lord Jesus Christ passed over from death into life, the church invites her members dispersed throughout the world together in vigil and prayer. For this is the Passover of the Lord, by which, by hearing his word and celebrating his sacraments, we share in his victory over death. Let us pray. O God, through your Son, you have bestowed upon your people this brightness of your light. Sanctify this new fire and grant that in this Paschal feast we may so burn with heavenly desires that with pure minds we may attain to the festival of everlasting light through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. May the light of Christ, gloriously rising, dispel the darkness of our hearts and minds.
The light of Christ,
thanks be to God.
The light of Christ,
thanks be to God.
The light of Christ,
thanks be to God.
Rejoice now, heavenly host and choirs of angels, and let your trumpets shout salvation. For the victory of our mighty King. Rejoice and sing now. Glorious splendor, for darkness has been vanquished by our eternal King. Rejoice and be glad now, Mother Church, and let your holy courts in radiant light resound with the praises of your people. All you who stand near this marvelous and holy flame, pray with me to God the Almighty for the grace to sing the worthy praise of this great light. Through Jesus Christ, his Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with him in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our for he is the true Paschal Lamb, who at the feast of the Passover paid for us the debt of Adam's sin, and by his blood delivered your faithful people. This is the night when you brought our forebears, the children of Israel, out of bondage in Egypt, and led them through the Red Sea on dry land. This is the night when all who believe in Christ are delivered from the gloom of sin and are restored to grace and holiness of life. This is the night when Christ broke the bonds of death and hell and rose victorious from the grave. How wonderful and beyond our knowing, O God, is your mercy and loving kindness to us, that to redeem a slave, you gave a son. How holy is this night, when wickedness is put to flight, and sin is washed away. It restores innocence to the fallen and joy to those who mourn. It casts out pride and hatred and brings peace and concord. How blessed is this night, when earth and heaven are joined, and we are reconciled to God. Holy Father, accept our evening sacrifice, the offering of this candle in your honor. May it shine continually to drive away all darkness. May Christ, the morning star who knows no setting, find it ever burning. He who gives his light to all creation, and who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Let us hear the record of God's saving deeds in history. How God saved people in ages past. And let us pray that our God will bring each of us to the fullness of redemption. In the beginning, God created everything, the heavens above and the earth below. Here's what happened. At first, the earth lacked shape and was totally empty, and a dark fog draped over the deep while God's spirit wind hovered over the empty waters. Then there was the voice of God saying, "Let there be light." And light flashed into being. And God saw that the light was good. And God separated the light from the darkness. And God named the light day. And the darkness he named night. Evening gave way to morning. That was day one. And then God said, let there be a vast expanse in the middle of the waters. Let the waters above part from the waters below. So God parted the waters and formed this expanse, separating the waters above from the waters below. And God called the vast expanse sky. Evening gave way to morning, and that was day two. And then God said, let the waters below the heavens be collected into one place and congregate into one vast sea so that dry land may appear. God called the dry land earth. And the waters congregated below the seas. And God saw that God's new creation was good. And then God said, earth, sprout green vegetation, grow all varieties of seed-bearing plants and all varieties of fruit-bearing trees. And the earth produced vegetation, seed-bearing plants of all varieties and fruit-bearing trees of all varieties. And God saw that this new creation was good. Evening gave way to morning. That was day three. And then God said, lights, come out, shine in the vast expanse of heaven's sky, dividing day from night to mark the seasons and the days and the years. Lights, warm the earth with your light. God fashioned the two great lights, the brighter light to mark the course of the day, the dimmer light to mark the course of the night, and the divine scattered the night with the stars. God set them in heaven's sky to cast light upon the earth, to rule over the day and night, and to divide the light from the darkness. And God saw that this new creation was good. Evening gave way to morning. That was day four. And then God said, waters, swarm with fish and sea creatures, and let birds soar above the broad expanse of the sky. So God gathered huge sea creatures, all of the swarm of life in the waters, and every kind and species of flying bird, each able to reproduce its own kind. And God saw that God's new creation was good. And God spoke this blessing over them. He said, be fruitful and multiply. Let creatures fill the seas and let birds cover the earth. And evening gave way to morning. That was day five. And then God said, earth, generate life. Produce a vast variety of living creatures, domesticated animals and small creeping creatures and wild animals that roam the earth. And God made earth, creatures in a vast variety of species, wild animals and domesticated animals of all sizes and small creeping creatures along the earth, each able to reproduce in its own kind. And God saw that God's new creation was good. And then God said, now, let us conceive a new creation, humanity, fashioned according to our likeness and in our image, and let us grant them authority over all the earth, the fish and the sea and the birds and the sky, the domesticated animals and the small creeping creatures on the earth. God created humanity in God's image, created the male and female, and then God blessed them, saying, be fruitful and multiply. Populate the earth. I make you trustees to care for my creation and rule over the fish of the sea and the birds of the earth and every creature that roams across the earth. And God said to humanity, look, I've given you every seed-bearing plant that grows on the earth and every fruit-bearing tree. They will be your food and nourishment. As for all the wild animals, the birds in the sky and the small creeping animals, everything that breathes the breath of life, I've given them every green plant for food. And then God surveyed everything that God had made. And indeed, it was very good. And evening gave way to morning, and that was day six. So now you see how the Creator swept into being the spangled heavens, the earth, and all their host. And on the seventh day, with the canvas of the cosmos created, God paused from God's labor and rested. May none of God's wonderful works keep silence,
night or morning. Bright stars, high mountains, the depths of the seas, sources of rushing rivers, may all these break into song as we sing to Creator, Savior, and Holy Spirit. May all the angels in the heavens reply, Amen, Amen, Amen. Power, praise, honor, and eternal glory to God, the only giver of grace. Amen, Amen, Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who wonderfully created and yet more wonderfully restored the dignity of human nature, grant that we may share in the divine life of him who humbled himself to share our humanity, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. 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 So I want to share with you the story, remind you of the story of when the Israelites were delivered from slavery through the Red Sea. When the Israelites were fleeing slavery in Egypt, they looked back and saw Pharaoh and the Egyptians getting closer to them. In great fear of the Israelites, they cried out to God. And they said to Moses, "Was it because there were no graves in Egypt that you have taken us away to die in the wilderness? Do you not remember we asked you in Egypt, just let us stay here and serve the Egyptians and live? That's better than dying in the wilderness. Let us alone and let us just serve the Egyptians. For it really, truly would be better to just stay alive as slaves than to die free in the wilderness." But Moses said to the people, "Do not be afraid. Stand firm, for you will see the deliverance that God has in store for you tonight, the deliverance from the Egyptians. You shall never see these people again. The Lord will fight for you. All you have to do is keep still." Then God said to Moses, "Why do you cry out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward. But you, Moses, you lift up your staff, you stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it. That way the Israelites can go into the sea on dry ground. Then I will harden the hearts of the Egyptians so that they will go in after them. And so I will gain glory for myself over Pharaoh and all his army and his chariots and his chariot drivers. And the Egyptians shall know that I am God. They'll know that I am God when I have gained glory for myself over Pharaoh and his chariots and his chariot drivers." The angel of God who was going before the Israelite army moved and went behind them. And the pillar of cloud moved in from in front of them and took its place behind them. It came between the army of Egypt and the army of Israel. And so the cloud was there in the darkness, and it lit up the night sky. One did not come near the other all night long. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord drove the sea back by a strong wind that blew all night long until the waters were divided and dry ground was presented for the Israelites. They went into the sea on this dry ground with the water making a wall on the one side and a wall on the other side. The Egyptians pursued. They went into the sea after the Israelites, all of Pharaoh's horses and chariots and chariot drivers. And then morning came, and the Lord came in a pillar of fire and a cloud and looked down upon the Egyptian army and threw the Egyptian army into a panic. He clogged their chariot wheels so that they turned with great difficulty. The Egyptians said, "Let us flee from these Israelites, for it's obvious God is on their side. God is fighting for the Israelites against Egypt." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, so that the water may come back upon these Egyptians, upon their chariots and their chariot drivers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the water, and down came the sea, returning to its normal depth. And in the waters drowned the Egyptians. Before they could flee, the Lord tossed the Egyptians into the sea, all of their armies, their chariots, and their chariot drivers. The waters returned and covered them, and the entire army of Pharaoh that had followed them into the sea, and not one of them remained. But the Israelites, God's people, they walked out on dry ground through the sea. The waters formed a wall for them on the right side and on the left side. God saved Israel that day from the Egyptians. And Israel saw the Egyptians dead on the seashore. Israel saw the great work that God did against these Egyptians. So the people feared God and believed in God and believed in God's servant Moses. Then the prophet Miriam, Aaron's sister, took out a tambourine in her hand, and all of the women went out after her with tambourines in their hands, and they began dancing on the seashore, shouting and singing. Sing to the Lord, sing to God, for God has triumphed gloriously. Horse and rider he has thrown into the sea. Wisdom freed from a nation of oppressors,
a holy people, and a blameless race. She entered the soul of a servant of the Lord, withstood dread rulers with wonders and signs. To the saints she gave the reward of their labors and led them by a marvelous way. She was their shelter by day and a blaze of stars by night. She brought them across the Red Sea. She led them through mighty waters. But their enemies she swallowed in the waves and spewed them out from the depths of the abyss. And then, Lord, the righteous sang hymns to your name and praised with one voice your protecting hand. For wisdom opened the mouths of the mute and gave speech to the tongues of a newborn people.
Let us pray. O God, whose wonderful deeds of old shine forth even in our own day, you once delivered by the power of your mighty arm your chosen people from slavery under Pharaoh to be a sign for us of the salvation of all nations by the water of baptism. Grant that all the peoples of the earth may be numbered among the offspring of Abraham and rejoice in the inheritance of Israel. through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Let me tell you the story of the dry bones in the valley. Ezekiel says, "The hand of the Lord came upon me, and he brought me out by the Spirit and set me down in the middle of a valley, and it was full of bones. He led me all around them. There were very many lying in the valley, and they were very dry. And he said to me, 'Mortal, can these bones live?' I answered, 'O Lord God, you know.' Then he said to me, 'Prophesy to the bones and say to them, O dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God to these bones, I will cause breath to enter you, and you shall live. I will lay sinews on you and will cause flesh to come upon you and cover you with skin and put breath in you, and you shall live, and you shall know that I am the Lord.' So I prophesied as I had been commanded, and as I prophesied, suddenly there was a noise, a rattling, and the bones came together, bone to its bone. I looked, and there were sinews on them, and flesh had come upon them, and skin had covered them, but there was no breath in them. Then he said to me, 'Prophesy to the breath, prophesy, mortal, and say to the breath, Thus says the Lord God, Come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live.' I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived and stood on their feet, a vast multitude. Then he said to me, 'Mortal, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They say, Our bones are dried up and our hope is lost. We are cut off completely. Therefore, prophesy and say to them, Thus says the Lord your God, I am going to open your graves and bring you up from your graves, O my people, and I will bring you back to the land of Israel, and you shall know that I am the Lord when I open your graves and bring you up from your graves, O my people. I will put my spirit within you, and you shall live. And I will place you on your own soil, and then you shall know that I, the Lord, have spoken and will act. Thus says the Lord. Lord, hear my prayer. And in your faithfulness, heed my supplications. Answer me in your righteousness. Enter not into judgment with your servant.
For in your sight shall no one living be justified.
For my enemy has sought my life. He has crushed me to the ground. He has made me live in dark places like those who are long dead. My spirit faints within me. My heart within me is desolate. I remember the time past. I muse upon all your deeds. I consider the works of your hands. I spread out my hands to you. My soul grasps to you like a thirsty land. O Lord, make haste to answer me. My spirit fails me. Do not hide your face from me. Or I shall be like those who go down to the pit. Let me hear of your loving kindness in the morning, for I put my trust in you. Show me the road that I must walk, for I lift up my soul to you. Deliver me from my enemies, O Lord, for I flee to you for refuge. Teach me to do what pleases you, for you are my God. Let your good spirit lead me on level ground. Revive me, O Lord, for your name's sake. For your righteousness' sake, bring me out of trouble. Of your goodness, destroy my enemies and bring all my foes to naught. for truly I am your servant.
Let us pray. Almighty God, by the Passover of your Son, you have brought us out of sin into righteousness and out of death into life. Grant to those who are sealed by your Holy Spirit the will and the power to proclaim you to all the world through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Christ.
So after the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. Suddenly, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. The guards, for fear, shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He's not here. He was raised, as he said. Come and see the place where he lay, and then go quickly and tell his disciples. He has been raised from the dead, and indeed, he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came near him, took hold of his feet, and worshiped him. Then Jesus said, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
All he said.
the Paschal mystery, dear friends, we are buried with Christ by baptism into his death and raised with him to newness of life. I call upon you, therefore, now that our Lenten observance has ended, to renew the solemn promises and vows of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God faithfully in his holy Catholic Church. Do you affirm and your renunciation of evil and renew your commitment to Jesus Christ?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty,
creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Savior. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread, and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to God?
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
May Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed upon us the forgiveness of sins, keep us in eternal life by his grace, in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, who made this most holy night to shine with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your church that spirit of adoption which is given to us in baptism, that we, being renewed both in body and mind, may worship you in sincerity and truth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, Creator, Redeemer, and Life Sustainer, be with you this moment and remain with you always. Amen. Amen. So we'll see you in the morning at 10 as we continue our celebration of resurrection. Until then, may the peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.